We are at Afro Asian Entrepreneurs Conference 2024, a collaborative initiative by Madripreneur Mentor X and NIBC, hosted at Indraprastha Institute of Information Technology, Delhi. We have with us Dr. Neha Khurana, Shanti Gyan Vidyapeeth, Dwarka. Ma'am, firstly, tell us about the main expectations from this event.
Yeah, thank you so much. I'm so privileged and happy to be here with all the entrepreneurs over here. And it was a great experience. Our students performed over here. And basically, this is all about the startups, the entrepreneurs' journey, whatever they, you know, they want to excel in their entrepreneurship. And the fundraising panelists were there. They were extremely good. I heard them. And nice to be over here. Thank you.
Ma'am, please tell us about the performance of your students in this conference.
Yeah, our students performed on Ganesh Vandana, and it was extremely good. They performed really well on the stage, though they were a bit nervous, but then after that, it was amazing performance by all of them.
Thank you so much for talking to TenNews. And we have with us Anil Sood, SP Chetna NGO. Sir, welcome in TenNews first of all, and please tell us about your expectations from this event.
See, there is a need to exchange the thoughts and information so that those who are budding investors or budding entrepreneur, they can get a direction, they can get a feel that how to go about, how to reach out. Because there is a gap of information available, and this conference will bring both together and may narrow the gap.
So which sessions or topics are you most excited about?
See, mentorship was the topic, because today most of the students, they don't have mentor. They lack mentorship. They lack direction. They are full of ideas. They are full of, opinions. They are full of information which is available to them, but to how to utilize and through whom to utilize, which is more important. So unless you get a proper guru, you cannot channelize your energies and thought process. And for that, this conference will definitely help the students.
Correct. This is also a tradition of Bharat. And how do you think this conference will benefit the career and the entrepreneurship?
See, once you get a direction, first and foremost important thing is get a direction. The moment you get a direction, you are bound to progress. Then nothing stops you. There is nothing which can stop you. So long as you get a good direction, good mentor, and good and clear thinking that what is to be done and how it is to
Delhi.
Be done.
And we have with us Poonam Budhiraj, educator, research analyst, as well as author. Ma'am, firstly, welcome in TenNews. What are the main expectations from this conference?
I would like to say that the 21st century learning skills, if we are able to educate the children about them, for being a successful entrepreneur, you should have tenacity, you should have the quality of adaptability, you should have an open mindset, and you should be ready to face challenges. So all these things can be best done by an educator, by a mentor, and that educator or mentor can enter into industry relationships. And at the school level and at the college level, we can have a lot of, workshops, we can have internships, we can have competitions where children themselves are making business plans. They are coming up with sustainable development ideas, because technology is changing day by day.
Correct.
And challenges are coming up every day. And so we have to make the generation ready to face that challenge. It should not be that once I fail, okay, I'm done. I will not try again. That should not be the spirit. So
yes.
The spirit should be to go on, to find the kill. So such things can happen through these conferences when students interact with each other, students see the mentors talking. So this kind of learning experience, this kind of environment is very, very useful for them.
Correct. As a panelist, please tell us about your topic.
My topic would be the stepping stones, as I said, to innovation, to technology, for entrepreneurship in this ever-changing world today. So my topic would be that, and I would be stressing upon these qualities again, these points again, of adaptability, adjustability, tenacity, resilience, which is very, very important in the day today, to keep yourself updated and to have a very open mindset, to take feedback, very positively, because feedback sometimes hurts our ego and we are not able to take the feedback.
Positive.
But if we take it in a positive manner, yes, we can improve and we can do better. I mean, looking at India winning the World Cup in the last overs, that itself is a big, lesson to all of us, that anything can happen anytime. And it's just that we don't have to give up. We have to have a very open mindset. We have to take the feedback of everyone and we have to be ready to face the situation.
Thank you so much for talking to Tenmi. We have with us Yashika Arora, published author and also our 12th pass students only. Firstly, tell us about the expectations which you have about this conference.
So first of all, hello everyone. I'm Yashika Arora. I'm a published author, a former child model, Buddhist practitioner, and a sports enthusiast. And I am very obliged to be here. And from this meeting, I want to have a takeaway that all the aspiring entrepreneurs out there have a learning and have a very good experiences. I've heard a lot of panelists till now, and I've seen how confident they are, how they solve the problems of having a right mentor, of fundraising, and I expect myself to also become an entrepreneur in the future. With all the takeaways, I want to learn and put it all in my life to be successful.
As you said, you want to become an entrepreneur. So how do you think this conference benefits from your career? And
I think this conference is a very big platform for every youth out there, and everybody should watch it. And being a youth, I think for teenagers especially who think of becoming successful, I think it starts from being a better human, not only just educational background, but from a social front as well. I am myself 12th pass out, and I realize how much burden it is academically. But still, I think beyond academics also there is a world and you should explore it. And I think developing your skills is very important. So I think if we watch this panel, speaker list and everything, then you will get to know how speakers out there perform, how you have to have a good exposure and experience altogether.
And we have with us Darsh Juneja, a youngest author awardee in this conference. Please tell us about your book first.
Yes, my book is a collection of 11 stories. It all begins with us. It's a very delightful book with unmissable stories from my life. Some are fiction, but most of the stories are from my life. I have taken one lesson, each lesson like education. I have based a story on it, like how real life experiences of my life, that what education has taught me in an easy way in a story. People tell in like their big 20 minute speeches. I have only told in a 500 word story. I have explained them with a short 10 word moral.
Okay, when it is coming to the market?
I expect it to come this month or the other month. I am telling you, it will be a good book. Please buy this in market, as this is for the youth. I am a youth. I am a Gen Z. So this is for the Gen Z. Like, these are stories from the Gen Z's life, like education from Gen V's point of view.
What's your feeling as an awardee of this conference, a youngest author?
I am feeling very good. Like, I am getting awarded in the Afro-Asian Conference 2024 by many ambassadors and his excellencies. So I am very proud of myself that I have done this and I have reached this point.
Thank you so much for talking to Tenews, and all the best for
you.
We have with us Samaira Bhatia, an awardee in this conference. Please tell us about the award which you get in the conference and what's your feelings?
I'm really grateful to be here, and I would like to go to Africa one day. And it's a pleasure to be here, and this award means a lot to me. And this is a great opportunity in performing in front of so many people, in front of so many high standard people. So it's like very nice, and I feel really nice to be here.
Please tell us about your achievement
for which you got the award.
I got the award because actually I used to speak really nicely. And I appreciate Nancy ma'am and RevUp family for helping me and guiding me this path. And she's like a lightning star for me, and she taught me everything to do, and everything that I did in my life, it's all because of her. If she wasn't there, then I would have not accomplished this award.
All the best for your journey ahead. Thank you. Thank you so much for talking to 10 News. Thank you.
Thank you.
And we have with us Dr. Nancy Ahuja, Managing Director of MentorX. First of all, welcome in 10 News, and please tell us about the objectives of the Afro Asian Entrepreneurs Conference 2024.
Thank you so much. Namaskar sabko. I'm Dr. Nancy Juneja, CEO of RevUp and Global Chairperson of MentorX. And definitely I will say ki Afro Asian Conference 2024 ek aisa mauka hai, it is a experience where Asia and Africa is coming together. Yahan pe we have students, entrepreneurs who are very well known from overall Asia and African countries, and this is something to foster relation, not just between the country but between the different nations. So I feel companies like us, all of us, all the partners, MentorX, RevUp Life Skills, Lucrate Ventures, Hover Robotics, many of the one, even media partners like 10 News, everyone is supporting and telling that when Indians go outside, we also seek support, and when they are here, we all are there to support them in the ecosystem. Always and forever, there for them.
What are key themes and the topics the conference covered?
The key thing of the conference was innovation or evaporate. So innovate or evaporate. We have to innovate. We have to have a good startup ecosystem so that we help each other. And that is how, you know, I want ki we all should come together and we should work on the key factors, which is startup growth, mutual growth of the country, and collaboration. Competition is one thing, but trust me, collaboration over competition is the main thing.
How has been the response for this conference?
The conference response has been amazing. As you can see, there were around 800 registrations, out of which only few were selected. And there are a lot of African students, Asian students, embassy support, NIBC support, all of it, which is right there with us. Many of the people, university partners, school partners are there. So definitely we look forward to it.
Thank you so much, Dr. Nancy Ahuja. नमस्कार, हमारे साथ अंजू कवात्रा जी मौजूद हैं. जैसा कि आप जानते हैं, कवि और कवयित्री जो हैं कहीं ना कहीं कल्पना के आकाश में पंछी की तरह उड़ते नज़र आते हैं. उनके जो विषय होते हैं वो कल्पना से भी परे हो सकते हैं, ऐसा कहा जा सकता है. मैम, आपने कवि की दुनिया में अपनी एक खास जगह बनाई है, और मैं कहूँ कहीं ना कहीं साहित्यिक दुनिया में आप कविता के तौर पर अपनी एक खास जो है छाप छोड़ी है. कैसे देखती हैं आप अपने इस सफ़र को?
मेरा ये सफ़र यूँ तो कॉलेज में टाइम में शुरू हुआ था 1979 में, पर फिर मैंने छोड़ दिया. दो तीन साल करने के बाद छोड़ दिया. अब कोविड टाइम में मैंने फिर से 2020 में इसको स्टार्ट किया, और तीन बुक्स मेरी आ चुकी हैं, शोक अल्फाज, तपिश जीवन की, और शब्दों का सफ़र छपने गई है. और 17 मेरा साझा संकलन है, काव्य संकलन में कहानियाँ भी हैं. सीखने की कोई उम्र नहीं होती है
जी,
सीखने की कोई उम्र नहीं होती है. हर काम के लिए जिद ज़रूरी होती है.
बिल्कुल.
अगर आपके अंदर जिद है, जुनून है काम करने के लिए, तो कोई भी उम्र कम नहीं है. मैं अभी 65 इयर्स की हूँ, और मैंने अभी लिखना स्टार्ट किया है. आप सोचिए,
भले ही प्रेरणा स्रोत आपकी ये, मैं कहता हूँ बायोग्राफी भी ज़रूरी है, ऐसा लगने लगा है. हालांकि मैम, आप कैसे मानती हैं कविता के अंतर क्या गुण आपको लगते हैं कि होने चाहिए? आपने कविताएं लिखी हैं, साहित्य में आपका अपना एक खास योगदान है, कैसे क्या मानते हैं?
कविता तो भावों भाव जो आते हैं वो कविता में उतर जाते हैं. समाज में से जो हम सीखते हैं, समाज में जो हम देखते हैं, वही भाव जो है कविता में आ जाते हैं. वही शब्द कलम जो है वो बड़े बहुत अच्छे तरीके से पन्नों पर उकेर देती है, जो कविता बन जाती है.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद मैम 10 न्यूज़ से बातचीत करने के लिए. ये प्रेरणा है आप, और आपने बताया कि किस तरीके से कविता जो है नियमों की मोहताज नहीं है, बल्कि जो भाव हमारे मन में है उनको किस तरीके से प्रदर्शित करना है ये आप पर निर्भर करता है. तो आप भी कवि बन सकते हैं. आप देख रहे हैं 10 न्यूज़ नेटवर्क, मैं हूँ आपके साथ हिमांशु शर्मा.